welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're continuing the beginner series, and today we're going to teach you how to create melody from your mind. This is the biggest problem I see in production, is that we deviate from our original idea, and I've gone over in our other videos how to translate your song ideas. I'll leave a link in the video where you can click the video, and that'll take you to how to translate your song ideas into reality. This video is going to go over your original intent in a song. Okay, so what happens as producers and songwriters and artists, we come out with an idea, and then slowly over time, we start to neglect and, you know, deviate, get away from our original idea. That's where we start to have music theory issues, especially when we don't understand specific, concepts in music theory. Okay, so you don't need to understand music theory to the maximum degree when you're first just getting your idea out there, but you do need it to complete your idea. So let's turn our tempo to 73. Now, just a quick story is when I used to begin producing, I was writing long piano melodies in chord progressions. I had no knowledge of music theory, and it was a beautiful song. I posted it on Facebook. I think I deleted the video because I took down the videos or whatever, but it was a long time ago, and it was very powerful, because what I did was I listened to my mind, and my mind was telling me, what do I want to hear next? What do I want to hear next? That's all I did, was listen to my mind. And nowadays what we do habitually and subconsciously is we deviate from that because the computer allows us to do something that deviates from that. So your goal is to translate what you have, what your intent is. Now, I understand you're going to have to understand music theory to understand chords, harmonization, chord progressions, common chord progressions, you know, melody principles, bassline principles, etc. But, you know, when you're starting, you want to just have these melody principles laid out. So this is called the pseudo leading tone. It's a concept we use in the Western world as to which tones we want to hear next. We grew up in a culture, depends on which culture you grew up in, and in that culture, you expect to hear certain tones after the next tone. And we call those pseudo leading tones, because there's another term in music theory called leading tones, which are completely different. So we call these pseudo leading tones, pseudo meaning fake. But your mind is most powerful when songwriting. So let's right click, go to piano roll. I have loaded up a piano. We're going to create a melody that's very long, just from tones that we want to hear. Now, I can't sing, so I may be a little off pitch for what the piano, what I want to hear next, but we're going to start on any key. I'm literally going to close my eyes, not using any scales, not using any chords, not using anything. We're just going to create a melody from our heart, from our mind. We're going to listen to our mind and let the mind guide us through a song. So I'm going to close my eyes now, and I'm clicking here at C. So we're not going to go over everything about melody, like the note lengths, the fine tune, velocities, the dynamics, the riffs, the themes, the motifs. We're not going to go over all that right now. We have a whole course at BusyWorksBeats.com on music theory. You can check it out at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. It's the music theory essentials package going over all the musical aspects. So my ear wants to hear it. It's very low, so I want to hear. So if I whistle it, I'm going to do that in a bass tone. And we're also going to make sure the timing is right. So one, two, three. I know that was off. And then we're going to repeat that. Dun, 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 dun. And then we're going to go. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Way off tune. I understand. I can't sing. I make that disclaimer almost every video. We're letting our mind guide us through. We're not letting the computer tell us what to do. So it goes dun, dun, dun. And we're going to repeat that. Dun, dun, dun. In the lower sound. Dun. And now you're going to realize when you're writing your songs, sometimes you're going to make shapes with your mouth, because you're subconsciously trying to recreate that sound using your vocal cords, but you're not saying anything. So you're going to be making shapes with your mouth and moving tones. So for example, if you have the wrong tone, up here, you're going to shape your mouth and then you're going to get it to the right tone. And maybe that's the tone you wanted to hear. So for those who understand what I'm talking about, that's what we're getting into when we're letting our mind guide us. Now, I don't want it to go da-na-na-na anymore. I want it to go da-na-na-da-da. Did I want to raise the energy? So now we're changing the mood of the song, because before it sounded a little melancholy and sad. Now hopefully I remember that. That's why you should record your audio before doing that. So let's just keep working up the energy. Now I forgot how it was now, but you know, that's why you need to record your intent first and then try and translate that. All right, we're gonna figure out as we get there. Now this one struck the note a little too early, so we're gonna extend that note out. So this is, we're just listening to our mind. Again, I struck the note too early, so we're going to move that over. Now you're going to start to notice, okay, we're using all the white notes, if you've noticed that so far. We're just going up and down the white notes. Now this is what we create, what's called a scale. Now, in music theory, you can either stick to a scale or you can actually deviate from scales. And that's why we have a whole video on why traditional music theory is confusing, because everything is based on a scale, which is a man-made thing. We just listen to our mind tell us what we want to hear next, and then we create a scale from that. So scales are just different preferences of notes which go in sequence. In this case, it's all the white notes starting from C. So that's why all these notes sound like they're together. Okay, so let's start from the beginning and let's listen to what. Now, you can tell I didn't go by my original idea because I would have had some quicker notes in here, but I forgot the idea. I should have recorded it. So let's do that. Now we're going to change up the rhythm. It's going to go. So it's going to go. One, two. So we're going to stick to the scale so far. Now in my mind, I think we have a note that's outside of the scale, but we're not there yet. So bum bum. Now in this case, you know, if you're watching everything, velocity plays a huge role in melody. So right now I'm going to start altering velocity. Now again, we go over this in the music theory essentials, but I'm just going to point it out here because I go dun, 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 and then the volume goes up. So we're going to copy that same pattern. So we might as well just copy the MIDI. So we're going to start on A. Now some of these notes are flat, so we're going to fix those. hit shift up just to transpose it up to the next note, which is the white note B. We're going to change the velocity as well. So the same pattern is repeating here, and this is very common in melody. We compose via shapes and riffs, different shapes of melody. Now this note is not correct, so it should be, let's listen to it. So let's use that same passage here, whatever you want to call it. Okay, we call it specifically a motif in this case. So we're going to use that same shape, same note value, and just change that bass note. So we're listening to our mind, people. And your mind is going to give you patterns and things that we're so used to in a music. That's what creates the magic of melody. Okay, and then we're going to wrap it up and bring it back to the beginning. Now this melody is longer than 8 bars. It's 9-bar melody. Usually you're doing melodies for about 8 to 16 bars, or 4 bars. So now you can see how the energy completely changed throughout this melody. We have no supporting harmonizations, and if you want to understand the support of the harmonies and different ways to build chords around this, you have to get the music theory essentials so that you understand the reasoning behind figuring out this stuff. So now you can see how melody can be much more complex than the average songwriter song that you hear on the radio. Okay, it can be very complex. It can even go longer than 8 bars, 16 bars. It can be a 32-bar melody. So, you know, learn the secrets of melody. Learn what makes this a melody. Learn why it works. Learn what notes go together, which notes, you know, how we define melody. All that is explained in the music theory essentials. And the exercise today was just to listen to your mind. Your mind is going to guide you to the next tone. And the further you deviate from your mind is when you start to encounter issues. So I really want you to take the time to record as many ideas as you have into audio form and really try your hand at translating those ideas into the songwriting program that you use. Okay, and we click that video in the annotation that's going to take you to the other video of how to translate your song idea in your DAW. Okay, so take these two techniques and really focus in on what is your mind saying to you. Your mind is built up of what we call intuition, years and years of experience built up into your mind. Your mind has answers quick. But what happens is, as humans, we spend too much time thinking about something and we deviate from that original intuitive answer. And your intuition was built over however many years you are, plus the time it takes to make that song. So if you write a song in 30 minutes, it didn't just take you 30 minutes. It took you your age and years plus 30 minutes because you were building up your intuition over that time and your experience and your culture. All right, so these are powerful songwriting techniques that you can apply right away. Okay, so listen to your mind, people, and click that link below and sign up for the Music Theory Essentials email, because when you sign up with your email, you're going to get special bonuses, and we're going to leave those for you to discover. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.